It's the Festival of Dreams, and we love speaking of dreams. I bumped into Rose at the, which is the place that you're working at today?
Rockpool Publishing.
Rockpool Publishing. And Rose, you are the author of this wonderful set, Dream Reading Cards, and you do all this other stuff. How did you get into this world of dreams?
Always been fascinated with dreams. My grandmother used to interpret dreams for me.
Wow.
Which was great. And then eventually I wrote a Dictionary of Dreams, which is a huge book. Sold really well, over 500,000 copies. So I figured I was on a good thing. People wanted to know about dreams.
When you're on a good thing, stick to it. Now, why are dreams important for us as a guide?
Because your subconscious has so many messages that you miss in your conscious life. So why, you've got all this information, why are we making the most of it?
Mm.
That is the reason.
So your nonna had this insight. You picked it up from her. Did she pick it up from someone else before that in her life?
It was always passed down. We have a lot of superstitious traditions.
Yeah.
We believe in psychic stuff, so it was passed down.
What I love about the Italians, recently when I was in Italy, you have the Vatican right there at the back door, and it's a monument to the world. And then when you talk to the people in the streets, they live their life as if, hey, you know, I know smoking's bad, but when I get cancer, I'll worry about it today or tomorrow.
Yeah.
There's a very relaxed attitude to life. And the psychic world was very much a part of that world as well.
That's right. It was. So you lived in duality.
Mm.
And I try to have that approach with these cards. So I gave it the psychology and the scientific background and balanced it with intuition and psychicness.
Mm-hmm.
So I hope I gave it that flavour. You know, we Italians love a bit of spice.
Yeah.
And pasta, you know, the substance. So that's how I created the cards.
So tell me, can we see some of the cards?
Sure.
Because I bet you there's lots of colour in there that you've put in.
Yeah.
And where did you get the insight for all this? So I'll hold some of them up here for the camera.
Sure.
So here we go. Look at this. Nice colour. Did you come up with all these?
I did come up with all the ideas because subconsciously our brains see in images, not in words or
yes,
logic.
Yes.
So everyone who looks at those cards can see something a bit different.
A picture tells 1,000 words.
That's right.
So
yeah.
What would be a classic thing that people would say to you that they dream about? Is there a common thread of dreams that happen?
We have about 22 common dreams we share all over the world. One of the most common ones that would be your teeth falling out and flying.
Yes.
And snakes. They're probably the ones that I'd say.
And what does it represent? What does it represent for someone? Is there a common answer to it?
Yeah, there is. And it's interesting, it's worldwide. So when you dream of flying, you dream that you want to be free. You know, get rid of all the pressures in life.
Mm.
Whereas if you're falling, it's like, you know, you're not getting support.
Right.
You're falling down.
Right.
Snakes are about endings, regeneration. Because the snake sheds its skin. So it's coming to an end of a cycle.
Yeah.
Yeah, people are freaked out about
it.
I was chased by a snake, what does it mean? You know, that kind of thing.
What about in childhood? You know, I remember as a kid I used to dream all the time.
Yeah.
And I sometimes would have the same dream recurring.
Yes.
Then I got through my teens and I very rarely dream now. Or maybe I'm not paying attention to it, I don't know.
It's true. Children dream, they tend to remember more because their brain's not as cluttered as ours. But there is a skill in remembering dreams. We all dream. That's what people say, I don't dream. I said, no, we all do dream, including your animals. Even your cat and your dog actually have dreams.
Yes, I watched my little Maltese Terrier the other night and she was asleep. She's snoring, this little thing. Anyway, she's 14 years old and all of a sudden she starts doing this, moving her head around and I'm thinking she's dreaming about something.
She's chasing rabbits.
Something like that, hopefully.
Yes, that's right.
So for you, in terms of dreams, when you're giving a reading to someone, do you pick up on the cards or do you get messages coming through that you need to tell people or do you read it from the cards?
No, I read it from the cards. So I don't have the psychic ability.
Yeah.
I have a high level of intuition.
Yes.
But I understand how the cards work with your subconscious mind.
Yeah.
So it's a little bit more scientific, but I have my intuition that tells me this is what's happening in your life.
Mm.
You know, and usually 2 weeks before the dream is when something happens to make you dream that dream.
Yeah. Well, there you go. Rose has got some great insights there. Dream reading cards. Now, can we go to your website to get these or do we go to Rockpool Publishing?
Best to Rockpool. Rockpoolpublishing.com.
Fantastic. The Festival of Dreams, the Conversation Arena, lovely Rose, an Italian with a difference.